Dear comrades and friends, I hope that this time my voice will reach you and that I will be permitted in this way to participate in your double celebration. Both events, the 10th anniversary of our American organization, as well as the Foundation Congress of the Fourth International, deserve the attention of the workers incomparably more than the warlike gestures of the totalitarian chiefs, the diplomatic intrigues, or the pacifist congresses. Both events will enter history as important milestones. No one has now the right to doubt that. It is necessary to remark that the birth of the American group of Bolshevik-Leninists, thanks to the courageous initiative of comrades Kennan, Shachtman, and Abern, didn't stand alone. It approximately coincided with the beginning of the systematic international work of the left opposition. It is true that the left opposition arose in Russia in 1923, 15 years ago. But regular work on an international scale began with the 6th Congress of the Comintern. Without a personal meeting, we reached an agreement with American pioneers of the 4th International, before all, on the criticism of the program of the Communist International. Then, in 1928, began the collective work which, after 10 years, led to the elaboration of our own program recently adopted by our international conference. We have the right to say that the work in this decade was not only persistent and patient, but also honest. The Bolshevik-Leninists, the international pioneers, our comrades across the world, searched the way of the revolution as genuine Marxists, not in the ends and wishes, but in the analysis of the objective march of events. Above all, were we guided by the preoccupation not to deceive others nor ourselves. We searched seriously and honestly, and some important things were found by us. The events confirmed our analysis as well as our prognosis. Nobody can deny it. It is necessary that we remain true to our program. It is to ourselves. It is not easy to do so. The tasks are tremendous. The enemies innumerable. We have the right to spend our time and our attention on the Jubilee celebration only insofar as from the lessons of the past we can prepare ourselves for the future. Dear friends, we are not a party as other parties. Our ambition is not only to have more members, more papers, more money in the treasury, more deputies. All that is necessary, but only as a means. Our aim is the full material and spiritual liberation of the toilers and exploited through the socialist revolution. Nobody will prepare it and nobody will guide it but Bolshevik-Leninist. I repeat, nobody but ourselves. The old internationals, the second, the third, that of Amsterdam, we will add to them also the London Bureau, are rotten through and through. The great events which rush upon mankind will not leave of these outraged organizations one stone upon another. Only the Fourth International looks with confidence at the future. It is the World Party of Socialist Revolution. There never was a greater task on the earth. Our party demands each of us totally and completely. Let the Philistines hand their own individuality in empty space. For a revolutionary to give himself entirely to the party signifies finding himself. Yes, our party takes each one of us wholly. But in return, it gives to every one of us the highest satisfaction. The consciousness that one participates in the building of a better future, that one carries on his shoulders a particle of the fate of mankind, and then one's life will not have been lived in vain. The fidelity to the cause of the toilers requires from us the highest devotion to our international party. Of course, the party can also be mistaken. By common effort, we will correct its mistakes. In its ranks can penetrate unworthy elements. By common effort, we will eliminate them. New thousands who will enter its ranks tomorrow will probably be deprived of necessary education. By common effort, we will elevate the revolutionary level. But we will never forget that our party is now the greatest lever of history. Separated from this lever, every one of us is nothing. With this lever in hand, we are all. We aren't framing a party as other parties. It is not in vain that the imperialist reaction persecutes us madly, following furiously at our heels. The assassins at its services are the agents of the Moscow Bonapartistic clique. Our young international already knows many victims. In the Soviet Union, they number by thousands. In Spain, by dozens. In other countries, by units. With gratitude and glow, we remember them all in this moment. Their spirits continue to fight in our ranks. The hangmen think in their obtuseness and cynicism that it is possible to frighten us. They err. In their blows, we become stronger. The bestial politics of Stalin are only politics of despair. It is possible to kill individual soldiers of our army, but not to frighten them. Friends, and especially you, my young friends, we will repeat again in this day of celebration, it is not possible to frighten us. Dear comrades, 10 years were necessary for the Kremlin clique in order to strangle the Bolshevik party and to transform the first worker state into a sinister caliph. 10 years were necessary for the Third International in order to stamp into the mire their own program and to transform themselves into a stinking cadaver. 10 years. Only 10 years. Permit me to finish with a prediction. During the next 10 years, the program of the First International will become the guide of millions. Inches revolutionary millions will know how to storm earth and heaven. Long live the Socialist Workers' Party of the United States. Long live the Fourth International.